Chief, what are you doing on Jill's bed? We have to be invited.
That's never been clear.
Yeah, Jill loves a loose boundary.
Besides, I peed on this bed a year ago, so it's technically mine.
What's in your mouth?
Hmm?
Chiefy, what you got there?
Oh,
no! You ate Jeremy?
You mean Jill's closed door under the covers buzzing machine?
You can say vibrator. It keeps her happy and independent.
I know, exactly! Like, I wanted some of that.
Oh, it's broken. And there's a new Property Brothers on tonight.
Oh, those dudes are so different.
Oh, yeah. One sells property and the other fixes it up. You can tell from their clothes.
Yeah, I could tell them apart completely nude standing in front of a brick wall, but, I mean, that's neither here nor there. Ah, I should probably hide the evidence.
Oh, no, Chief. I don't think you should.
Huh? Okay, I get it. Whoa.
You don't like being chased. But I also have needs in this relationship.
There is no relationship. I hate you.
Well, screw you!
Screw you, too!
Honey! I need you!
Okay, we'll pick this up later.
This isn't a game! I despise you!
Are you okay? Is Bubbles harassing you again?
Ugh. He parades around here wearing nothing but a collar, and I'm the one with HR on my ass.
The real problem is that Jill's bedroom and sometimes bathroom robot is not sitting well.
Oh, no. Okay. Well, I think Jill needs to take you to the vet.
Honey, it will pass naturally. All I need is a patch of grass, ray of sunshine, gentle breeze.
Aw, Chief, I'm sorry, but... Jill!
No, not Jill, not the vet!
Hey, you brought me in here. What did you want me to do?
I wanted you to give me a tummy nuzzle, or a cuddle puddle, or a muzzle kablubble, or a tummy rubby belly boop.
Guess what? I brought you some special treats. They're right there.
Mm-hmm.
In my backpack. Go on.
Have some.
The last cat that fell for that was never heard from again.
You think I don't know a catnapping sack when I see it? I don't need your help.
Go ahead, pretty kitty. Yeah.
Oh, look at you. Scared, anxious, trapped in a cycle of compulsive eating and scary vet visits.
Don't forget the occasional dental floss that has to be pulled from my rectum.
I would never. What if I told you it doesn't have to be this way?
Go on.
I think you'd get a lot out of group.
Oh, God, I can't believe I fell for that.
Sometimes it helps to talk things out. Wouldn't it be nice to go a month without having your stomach pumped?
Six of one.
Well, I hate it when you're gone. Jill always turns it into a girl's night.
Ooh, what's your name?
Oh, my God. Besides, if you joined group, it would bring us closer together. You know what keeps me happy and independent?
What?
Helping group members blossom.
Oh, again? I trusted you!
Chief ate my vibrator. I'm a little embarrassed.
Oh, don't be silly. Let me just take a quick Polaroid of you. New policy.
Well, Chief's at the vet again.
What happened to him?
Same as usual. Chief ate something he shouldn't have. This time it was Jill's vibrator.
Sounds like Jill is really leaning in.
By the way, his prognosis is excellent.
Oh, say that at the start of the story.
Oh, please, that wasn't a story. No, you'll know when I tell a story. Like, did I ever tell you about the time I found that old doll?
Yes!
And I thought it was...
A real baby!
But it wasn't. Well, that's a story.
You certainly think so.
Besides, if Chief wasn't fine, I wouldn't wait to tell you. Okay, I'm not a sociopath.
I'm not a sociopath.
I'm not a whatever you guys said. Sociopath.
Anything you'd like to add, Nibbles?
Nope.
Well, that was a lot of talk about a dog who's not even a member of the group. I'll get us back on track. I've decided I'm in love with Darla.
Oh, what kind of shoe is Darla?
She's not a shoe, but I look past that. She's my tortoise me a mortis. Latin, and she's warming up to the idea of getting back together.
Oh, that's wonderful, Shell.
Don't flood your basement just yet. Lindsay's made it clear she's not willing to let me go without a fight.
Well, she's a shoe.
Exactly. She was designed to hold on for dear life. She's clearly obsessed, and I'm worried that Lindsay might hurt Darla, or worse, hurt me.
Uh-huh. Tabitha, usually you would have pulled focus by now. Is everything okay?
I'm getting love all day long from the men in my life, and it is good. Let's get back to an important issue of how your owner will fully enjoy Property Brothers without her vibrator.
Cosine.
Hey, Tabs, you know, you might get more out of group if you started telling the truth. I mean, how can you expect them to help when they still think you're living with Brett and Stelios?
I need nothing from group.
Fine, but you might get more out of our friendship if you started telling me the truth.
You want the truth? I cannot go back to Cat Cafe. A lunatic has made me his muse.
So stay with me. The lunatic at my place will mostly ignore you.
Just until I can think of something less depressing.
Fantastic!
Ah, we're losing him. It's time for chest compressions. I'm going in.
Come on. Boop. Boop.
Buzz driving is drunk driving.
So, what are you in for?
I'm here for no reason, like at all. I ate a couple of mittens. Do you know what mittens are?
Oh, I love mittens. Do I know what mittens are?
I had a heart attack.
Oh, no! And you're just letting us go on about mittens?
It was my 17th.
I don't even know why I'm here.
Oh, well, it kind of looks like you got your head stuck in a cone.
All I know is I really, really, really want to get at my balls, but I can't reach.
Who wants to tell him?
Hey, what'd you do to get thrown in here, big guy?
I ate my humans, well, I ate her this.
Dude.
Chief? Oh, hey! It's, name?
Chico.
Chico! I know this cat. What brings you here, friend?
Urinary bladder rocks.
Ooh, how did you eat those?
I'd kill to be here for urinary bladder rocks.
Yes, due to excess weight gain, which is due to too much food, which is due to my owner and best friend Kevin traveling a lot. Too much. It's too much.
Aw, Chico. No. Shh.
Sounds like you need to share.
This is a safe space.
Oh, boy. Ah! Oh, here we go.
You're sure it's okay if I stay with you?
Oh, yeah. But remember, you've got to be nicer than you've ever been before. I mean it, Tabs. These cats are vicious. When I first moved in here, I had the standard number of eyes, ears, and testicles. And let me tell you, I do not anymore.
Does a stranger sense danger in the house of a hoarder? Then Jellymont Juniper and introductions in order. I'm Percival, Sir Pa, but you can call me the Clean One.
And I'm Chazzery Lymph, the Miffing a Spleen One.
I'm Grubblerum, known as the Warm Wet One.
We are Conjointedly Jones, we're the Duet One.
I don't get it. Dangerous cats sing song to me?
Oh, our musical cat extravaganzas are the only thing that keep us from killing each other. So if you want to survive here, you have to join the fun.
I am not a joiner, and it does not look like fun.
Whoa! Well, joke's on you, because this is the most fun.
Hey. I didn't mean to scare you.
Why would I be scared? I'm just alone in my yard with a dangerous coyote.
You think I'm dangerous?
Did I say dangerous? No. No, I meant sexy. No, I meant dangerous. No, I meant...
Daddy!
Sorry, my human's calling. You know how it is. Oh, no, of course you don't, because you're wild and dangerous. Nope, gotta go.
Oh, Darla, the moonlight illuminates all of your wonderfully earned wrinkles. And I'm like, damn, girl.
Oh, Shell, you're making progress.
Oh, my God.
I thought you told her it was over.
I did.
Maybe I should talk to her.
No, Darla, it's not safe. There's no telling what that horngry beast will do.
She's coming closer.
Run, Darla, run!
Keep
walking.
When you least expect it.
Oh, look at the great gentleman protecting his wonderful damsel.
Shh, you'll wake her up.
Oh, now the hero is shushing me. If she fell in line, you wouldn't have to protect her fluffiness.
Yeah, musical theater's just not her thing.
I just hope she's worth it, because she didn't seem to give a rat's ass about you.
Yeah, well, your badonkadonk ain't all that.
That was 18, guys!
I guess I'm this big because I want Kevin to see me.
Mm-hmm. That one hit home.
Must lick. Can you see them from where you are? Honest to God, I don't even see them.
I hear that, Cat. I blow mines all over town, but now that I'm getting fixed, I'm scared I won't know who I am. Who am I if I'm not blowing mines?
Wait, do I know you?
I must have blown your mind.
No, I don't think that's it.
You ever had kittens?
Yeah, but I'm not sure what that has to do with it. What an odd question.
Okay, I'm gonna tell you guys something, and you can't tell Honey.
We don't know who that is. Go on.
I knew that Jill's Mr. Roboto was gonna make me feel blecky in my tummy, but I did it anyway.
Maybe this is the rock bottom we needed to take a long look at ourselves.
This feels like group.
Wait, this is what group is like? Huh. I always thought it was a contest to see who could be the most boring. Usually the turtle wins.
Hey, Shell's going through a lot of boring stuff right now.
So this is what Honey is always nagging me to do. Wow, she's right. It does feel good to share. Huh, what an emotional release. Whoa, wait a minute. What the? Jeremy?
Water!
Hey, I passed the baton!
Well, here I am, completely alone in my yard again. Totally vulnerable.
Shut up!
Go to hell! Where are you taking me?
What?
Ah, Chief's home. Okay, I've gotta go, but I'm sure I'll be out here vulnerable and alone later. Okay, just saying. Chief, welcome home! So how'd it go?
Wonderful.
Really?
Oh, yeah. A rabbit had a bunch of heart attacks, Chico peed out some rocks, and one dog was there because he was born with balls between his legs. Gross. Anyway, we all bonded. It's like I've always said, emotional connection. You know, that's where it's at.
At the vet?
Yeah, it was pretty amazing. I've come to a decision. I'm ready to do group.
Oh, wow. This is so great. You're gonna love it. I mean, Diablo is super annoying, but you can just tune him out.
No, I'm starting my own group with my friends from the vet. It's gonna be awesome. Good night.
Oh, no. Did the gallant swain oversleep?
What are you even saying?
You missed rehearsal.
What? Why didn't you wake me?
1, 2, 3.
Neglect is our dad, infection's our mother.
When we're not singing, we're killing each other.
There's always a place for you.
The gray one, you're out of the show.
But I'm Monocules Monroe, the gentleman cat from Microwave Mountain.
You know we have a zero-tolerance policy regarding missed rehearsals.
Who do I talk to about sleeping accommodations?
Ah, this is all your fault. Everyone hates you, and now they hate me. But you obviously don't care because you...
I'll kill you!
He's out of the show!
He's out of the show!
He's out of the show!
I have no faith in this show.
Well, you may or may not have noticed that Chief is having his own group outside.
Right, yeah.
I sat out there a while before I realized I was in the wrong place.
Fascinating. Lindsay's menacing yet erotic behavior has escalated, but I refuse to let her rob me of the life of scute-slamming happiness I could have with Darla.
I mean, it's totally within his right. I have no problem with it.
It detoxifies my masculinity to admit it, but I can't handle the Lindsay sitch on my own. I need help making it, go away, if you know what I mean.
Not here.
Where?
After group. I know someone.
It's just that I've been asking him for years to join our group.
That must be really frustrating. You know, that he refuses to join something that would obviously help you both and keep you from getting killed in your sleep.
Wonder what they're talking about.
You gotta help me!
Screw you!
You screw you!
Chief, stop! What's going on?
Squirrel break! Ah! Get him off me!
Watch
out! Get him off me!
Stay still! Try to... We can... Everyone self-protect!
Ah, he's in my fur! Get him off me!
Ah.
I did this!
Oh, he's everywhere! I'm covered in squirrel!
thank God. I thought you were Lindsay.
I mean, just keep walking. I know someone who can send Lindsay back to Zappos, if you know what I mean.
Really? Are you sure? She has not been gently used.
Trust me.
Okay. Who's the fixer?
Me.
Well, this is an unexpected turn of events. You sure you can handle it?
Can I handle it? You ever hear about the time two of those Stranger Things kids killed that hiker?
God, no.
How about when a certain handsome quarterback burned down a Jamba Juice?
No.
Or when a certain perky morning show host kept the Biebs in her basement for 3 days?
Not that either.
Exactly. My hooves have been in everything you can imagine, so yeah, I can handle your little shoe problem.
All right, you should know I don't condone violence, but I am aroused by it, so do your worst.
I'm regretting this already.
I don't understand why you're so mad. I thought you wanted me in a group.
Not a group, my group. Which, on a side note, you completely ruined today.
I was wondering, it seemed a little chaotic. Why does it matter whose group I'm in?
Because I know what you need to fix. I can help you be less impulsive, a better listener, sneeze more quietly.
My group has a word for how you're acting right now, and it rhymes with fudge mental.
I can help you with your vocabulary.
And this fudgy attitude is exactly why I didn't want to be in your group. I get enough criticism from you as it is.
Well, it's constructive criticism. I can help you understand the difference.
What?
No!
The gray one, help me!
All you had to do was join the fun. Turn, touch, step. Oh, no.
But, Grey One, we are friends, no?
You're on your own.
I will agree to star in your show if you let the Grey One back in and stop trying to kill him.
We already have our leading lady.
I got a DIY facelift for this.
That's okay. I just want to be one of the gang. I will be Chorus Cat.
You're a kitten again.
You can't just get together, chase squirrels, and call it group.
Nice stream.
Oh, thanks. I try to drink at least 2 bowls a day, so... but you don't care about that. You're just here to ravage me.
Actually, I was wondering, the pets that meet at your house...
are not food.
They come to talk, right?
And sometimes I give advice, but they will tear you limb from limb, so don't even try kidnapping me and taking me to your mysterious lair.
Actually, I just have a question. Is there such a thing as objective morality? Oh, sorry. Is that not the kind of thing you talk about?
You don't have a lair, do you?
Oh, no, I'm the one being called away. Oh, and by the way, that squirrel won't be bothering you anymore.
Why not?
I killed him. Good night.
Screw you, little friend. Screw you.
All right, you may want to turn away while I put Lindsay down for her dirt nap.
Do you think it's safe for me to say a few words to her?
Whatever, man.
Lindsay, I'm coming closer. Don't try anything. Lindsay, when we met, I was a shell of a tortoise. But the time we spent together filled me and my shell with feelings and liquids that I didn't know were possible. In fact, how about one more?
Okay, that's enough. Now I'll tell you what I told Meryl after her one-night stand with a certain frosted tip celebrity chef. Get out of here and forget this ever happened!
I'm sorry for being so judgmental.
That was the word!
Continue with your apology.
And it's stupid for me to think I can dictate who anyone else is. You don't need to change. I need to stop projecting on other canines. Not felines, though. They need my help.
So I don't need to be in a group?
Not unless you want to.
Oh, thank God. Because even with my guys, it was so boring. I mean, it was one thing when I was trapped in a cage at the vet, but to sit there by choice when all my instincts are telling me to run around and kick ass?
It was hard and not fun. I mean, not in the slightest. It was brutal. You know what I mean, right?
No, I do. I do,
but... Besides, I'm cured. One and done for me, babe. The only fun thing about group was meeting that awesome squirrel.
Well, okay, but...
Besides, I mean, we're good, you and me, you know?
Yeah. I mean, maybe we're not perfect, but we're good.
Now to sleep and dream about what hijinks I'll get into with my new BSF. That's best, squirrel friend.
Darla, now that we are rid of that deranged parasite, we can really focus on us and my needs.
Are you ever gonna tell me how you handle the situation?
I'll spare you the details, but if you're down to roleplay it, I could be persuaded. Lindsay? I should have known there was no way to contain her thrust lust forever. I hope you like psychosexual thrillers, Darla, because we're in for a triple feature.
As a matter of fact, I do.
So you've just screwed up your perfect life.
You're in deep crap.
Deep crap's a warm, soft place to land.
Rest us, way soft the pus.
You better learn to like it fast.
Live each day like it's your last.
Cause your life expectancy is not grand.
You're dead. Avoid any long-term plans.
I'll kill you.
We're the best and you're just the rest.
And I smell like a dead-rotten skunk. I'm Tabitha, but you can call me the stuck-up one.
There's always a place for you.
I feel lucky to be alive. Oh my goodness.
Bento. That's nice, Jen and Gabby.